Hi guys, I've gotten a lot of questions on whether it's a good idea to buy a used OBD scan tool, since you can save a ton of money by doing so. While I've answered those questions individually, I thought it would be a good idea to do a dedicated video on this, and especially since I haven't seen any coverage on this subject on YouTube. Now let's get this. While there's no straightforward yes or no answer to buying a used scan tool, my aim in this video is to cover the things you should know to help you make an informed decision on whether or not you should buy a used scan tool. The first thing to consider is that there are generally two kinds of scan tools in the market today, ones that require you to create a user account and the ones that don't. Scan tools that don't require you to create a user account or register tend to be more of code readers. They typically work out of the box without any setup required, may scan a couple modules in the car, turn off the check engine light, but are generally quite limited in terms of service functions. If you're in the market for this kind of tool and you've done your due diligence as you would when you're buying any used product, for example, finding out what works and what doesn't, you may well go ahead with buying this kind of scan tool used if it meets your needs. However, where the rubber meets the road is with buying used scan tools which require user accounts or product registration. These scan tools typically have professional functions, can usually scan all computer modules, and are designed for advanced DIY or shop use. Here are a couple things to consider before buying this scan tool used. Each professional scan tool is registered with a user ID. This usually includes an email address and will be required for updating the device or for buying a new subscription. While you may say you don't have any plans to purchase a subscription, keep in mind that if you ever lose the files on the tool or it ever becomes corrupt, you will need this account ID to restore the device or your files, especially if you intend to secure help from the customer service of the manufacturer. The second thing to note is that the registration process for this kind of tool binds the user account to the device serial number or other unique identifiers for the device. While you can buy a used phone and do a factory reset and start off on a clean slate, scan tools will still be tagged to the account they were registered to even after you've done a factory reset. Thirdly, a number of people sell stolen scanners, and it's worth noting that a number of manufacturers can remotely lock stolen scan tools once it's reported. Fourth, also determine whether or not the tool has an active subscription. This is important because some tools lose certain functions when they don't have an active subscription. So you may end up buying a tool and not have all the functions that it's advertised to do. I think you get the point. Buying used scan tools, especially the ones that require product registration to work, requires a lot of due diligence. So here's my take. Personally, I don't advise buying used scan tools for some of the reasons discussed, but if you're on a budget and you must, be sure to sort out the registration details. Find out if the service you're buying from can register the device with your details, especially your email. Ensure you're not buying a stolen device. Establish subscription status and functionality, and as much as possible, use an escrow service for the purchase, just for some extra insurance should things go south. Obviously, this is what I think. Let me know what you think in the comments. Hope this has been helpful. If it was and you've watched up to this point, you may consider subscribing, and I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.